Good morning, everyone. It's great to see so many smiling faces after several days of AWS reInvent. Hope everyone's been having a great show. We've been having a great time getting a chance to talk with you guys, and I'm super, super excited to share this information with you. My name is Don Meyer. I'm part of the product marketing organization at Palo Alto Networks, and I get to talk to you about a really interesting topic, ZTNA, and more importantly, what we're doing with ZTNA to enhance it, to make it ready for handling the security needs of today's hybrid workforces. What the heck does all that mean? Well, it's important to take a trip back and take a look at where we've come from. Interestingly enough, the last couple of years, we've seen a tremendous amount of change, just compressed into a relatively short period of time. To be able to accommodate for that, we've done some really interesting things. Thanks to the development through AWS, our DevOps teams have been busy crafting a bunch of new applications, getting new data sets out there for our users to be able to consume. And that's going everywhere but our data centers. At the same time, obviously, with the pandemic, we were forced to go work somewhere else. So work really started becoming less of a place we went to, more of just a function that we do. And that function tends to be more and more outside of corporate offices, accessing applications that are more and more outside of corporate offices. And in fact, when you look at it, before the pandemic, life was a little more simple, not necessarily easy, but definitely a little bit simpler. When everyone was coming into the offices, we had our full security stack, everyone would hit it, they'd go out get the access or the information that they needed. Life was relatively controllable. Well, when we went to the cloud and we went completely hybrid, we saw some interesting things happening. Now direct to cloud is the mainstay. That's what people want to do. No more backhauling of traffic back to corporate offices. It's latency sensitive. It really doesn't bode for a good experience. So we want to go direct to applications. What we're doing now essentially is just exploding our attack surface. The attack surface continues to grow and grow, but our security stack is still back at a corporate office. If we want to be able to address the security needs, we'd either have to continue to backhaul traffic, which is not good, or replicate security stacks at every one of these different application ingress points. That is an improbability. You cannot do that. What do we do? As an industry, we've had some tools at our disposal. We went and started looking at Zero Trust Network Access as a means to be able to overcome some of the challenges we face with direct-to-app access. Zero Trust Network Access has been around for a while. It was coined back in 2010. And think about it. In 2010, how different our application landscape was. Remember the big monolithic stacks that we used to have to utilize in order to be able to build applications out? All that's gone. Remote used to be a nice-to-have, best-effort kind of thing. Now remote is mission-critical. Things are vastly different than they were back in 2010. But the concepts that were designed back in 2010 still are prevalent today in ZTNA solutions. Trying to use ZTNA to address today's hybrid is a little challenging. And that's because the way it's architected, the way it's designed to be utilized. At its core, ZTNA, from a principal perspective, is the right approach. Eliminating trust, or at least eliminating explicit trust, and providing just direct to app access. So far, so good. The construct is right, but the early iterations of ZTNA maybe could use a little fine tuning. And it really stems from the fact of how they're architected. If you see in a typical ZTNA solution, you have an access broker that's waiting to field requests from users. That access broker will accept the request, challenge the user, force the user to provide credentials, validate that that user has access to that particular application, stitch that traffic together. Then that app broker does something very, very interesting. It goes away. I did my job. It's Miller time, baby. I'm done. I'm waiting for the next one to come along. Well, if you think about that, that's really an interesting opportunity because all we're doing is vetting trust once. Once I have established that my credentials are valid, my device is okay, I can get access to this application, now all of a sudden I have a trusted connection and there's nothing there to challenge that trust. So we went from no trust or zero trust, now to full trust on a connected session. What could possibly go wrong? What could be the challenge with that? Well, there's a couple of things to take into consideration. ZTNA, or traditional ZTNA solutions, tend not to really understand applications. They use FQDNs, or fully qualified domain names, IP addresses, and ports to be able to identify what the application is, and then stitch that connection together. Now again, think about how applications are now being designed. All the different sub-app functions that are now available that all have IP addresses. If you provide just blanket FQDN or a blanket IP address that covers that entire application stack, you may be exposing more of the application than you really want to. And if you think about modern collaboration applications, let's take Zoom for example. Zoom lets you do a lot of really cool things. Voice and video primarily, absolutely. But you can also do file share in Zoom. You can do screen captures on Zoom. You can alter and edit things on the screen in Zoom. Maybe you don't want everyone to be able to do that. Maybe you only want that functionality reserved for certain people in your organization. Without understanding applications fundamentally, there's no way to be able to put those restrictions on it, and then boom, you've just exposed more of that application than perhaps you wanted to. Kind of violates the principle of least privilege, and it exposes, again, you to additional threats. Another interesting thing about this particular model is it allows and ignores. Like I said before, once that access broker determines at that point in time that your credentials are okay, it stitches that connection together and goes away. A lot can happen during the course of a session. And think about this as well. 100% of breaches happen on allowed connections. You cannot breach something unless you're allowed to get in. Well, here's a handy exploit route right now that nobody's looking at. We vetted it once. Could the user behavior change? Quite possibly. Is phishing still a big problem that we have to deal with that goes after our credentials? Absolutely. So if we're only going to vet this one point in time, how do we know that this is the actual legitimate user that we want to be able to get access to the application? At the same time, how do we know that the device posture is not going to change? How do we know that the app behavior is not going to change, that someone might be exploiting an unknown CVE or an unknown vulnerability? Without having anyone in line, it makes it impossible to provide security. And now we're exposed again. Same thing. If I were to try and ingest malicious payload into that application, the access broker is just sitting back, sitting on the beach, having a Mai Tai. We need something in line with that traffic to make sure that there's nothing malicious being siphoned into or out of that particular application. And what about the data? Who's sitting in line to take a look at sensitive data that could be siphoned out as well? And finally, how are we doing this across not just private apps, not just coming back into our AWS VPCs, but across all the different applications that our hybrid users need to get access to? ZTNA 1.0 is a good first step, but it definitely has some challenges as it pertains to how our users are getting access to data and the applications that they're utilizing today. We think it's time for a different approach. And we're calling that ZTNA 2.0, leveraging some of the cool things about ZTNA, which is that direct-to-app access, but enhancing it to be able to overcome some of the challenges that we just discussed right now. So when you think about it side by side, ZTNA 1.0 has some pretty interesting challenges that ZTNA 2.0 really provides a solution for. True least privilege access, not just validating that the user and the device are okay, but also looking at the application and any sub-app functions and making sure that we're just giving exactly what that user needs at that particular time. Doing continuous trust verification. Again, not just a point in time, but throughout that entire session to make sure that the user, device, or application behavior conforms to what we expect. Doing continuous threat inspection throughout the entire course of that session to make sure that nothing malicious gets introduced. Doing that for all data in all applications. That's where we need to be. That's what our users expect from us. That's what ZTNA 2.0 delivers. ZTNA 2.0 is delivered from Palo Alto Networks on a product called Prisma Access. Prisma Access is our cloud-delivered SSE, or Security Service Engine, that powers our SASE solution. Its main purpose is designed to get any user anywhere in the world on any device to any application anywhere, and does so under the principles of ZTNA 2.0, providing true least privilege access because we understand users, devices, and applications. In fact, when we talk about applications, Palo Alto's first claim to fame was this App ID tool, the first product we brought to market. We brought with it an App ID function that sat and just gathered information about applications. It understands applications fundamentally from both signatures and heuristics to be able to map out exactly what the applications are and, more importantly, what they do, so that we can get very granular into defining what access we want to provide for our users. Once we've established that we've got the right user, the right application, the right device, everything is copacetic, we establish a connection under the guise of continuous trust verification. We will continuously monitor that session and make sure that the user device application behavior conforms to what we expect. Any deviations, we're in line. We can react to it. We can quarantine the user. We can disconnect that session. We can report, log, all the fun stuff before something malicious is introduced or information is taken away. And at the same time, with our full security stack, cloud delivered, nothing for you guys to be able to deploy, manage, or maintain, we can run our entire threat prevention stack against anything that's coming in or out of that application to ensure, even if there's an unknown vulnerability, anything that we see deviating from what we'd expect norm or anything that we don't understand, we can send up, explode, figure out what it is, and stop it in line right there. And we'll do that for all data across any application, not just SaaS applications. We don't have to force you to have multiple disparate tools to be able to figure out how to protect your data across any of these different applications. And again, do that for all apps. So when you think about it, bringing this to AWS, your developers are doing a great job building their applications, but we don't want to expose more of that infrastructure than we need to. We don't want to expose more of the applications than we need to. We can direct into AWS and use the principles of ZTNA 2.0 to ensure that our users are just getting access to the very things that they need. We've been an AWS partner for years. Happy to announce that Prisma Access is now available in the AWS marketplace as well. Encourage you guys to take a look. Give us a test drive. We not only have Prisma Access, but all sorts of other products to be able to provide protection for your VPC, as well as even your Kubernetes and containers. The real power is, irrespective of what product you're using, you get the same ZTNA 2.0 outcomes. Continuous trust, continuous threat for all applications with true least privilege access. That's the difference that we provide. This is kind of how we think the world should be when we start looking at providing protections for our hybrid users. As mentioned, we have a booth right down the hall here in the Security Boulevard, I guess that's what they call it. I'll be hanging out afterwards as well to answer any questions. Please, by all means, if you have questions on this or any of our other products, come down and talk to us. We're really happy to have the opportunity to speak with you guys. I hope you guys are enjoying the show. I hope this wasn't too painful for you. I know this is the last day, and it's like, oh boy, what are we doing here? This is a lot of fun for us. They saved the best for last for you guys. I really do appreciate all your time. Thanks so much again. We'll talk to y'all soon.